everyone, it's the RC Genius, and today I'm going to be showing you how to solder a wire on an RC car. Now, usually it's going to be a motor wire that's going to come apart because that's really the only wire that really shows. However, this could work for any wire on the RC car, RC truck, anything. So I hope you all find this video helpful, and let's get started. So, I have the red wire. This is the same red wire that came off of this motor. And what we need to do is we need to first cut off the end. So, we're just going to cut it off as close to the outside as possible. Let me get my camera to focus on that. There we go. Sort of. Not quite. There we go. Now, what we're going to do is we're just going to cut off right at the end, just like that, and it just flew across the room. Now what we need to do is we need to strip the wire and expose some of the metal wiring on the inside. Now you want to make sure that you do this really on the first try, because if you don't, you over time you're going to start getting a shorter and shorter wire, and at that point you might not be able to reach the ESC wire. So really, you have to do this carefully. Now, they do make a tool that can strip a wire. I'm just going to use wire cutters and very gently cut off the rubber insulator on the wire. Very, very carefully. Just like that. And it should slide off, unless if I missed a spot. Alright, let me get a little bit more on this side. Here we go. So as you see, I took off some of the red wire insulator, and now I have exposed some metal wire. So what we need to do now is we need to twist the wire together just like that until it becomes just a straight wire. Alright? Now what we need to do is we need to coat it with some solder. So this is called a soldering iron, and this right here is called solder. So we're just going to put a little bit on here, just like that. And then we just want to coat this wire with some of that solder. Not too much, but just enough. Now do be careful, because when the soldering iron is touching the wire, the wire actually will get very hot, so I'm actually going to hold the wire with the pliers, or the cutters. There we go. Now there is a coated wire, and now all we need to do is we just need to attach that to our motor. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the camera down just a little bit, so that way you guys can see a little bit better. And then we will attach it to the motor, and that will be pretty much it, because it's really something easy that can be done. So hang on one second. Okie dokie. So, what we are going to do now is we are going to now attach the wire to the motor. And this is pretty easy, just getting the motor wire terminal hot enough, and then just touching the red wire to that, and really it only takes a couple seconds for that solder to dry, and then you have a soldered motor wire. I'm going to add just a little bit more of the solder on here. Now if the wire does fall back off, that's totally normal. You're not always going to get it on the first try. But what you want to make sure is that you get enough solder on there that it won't fly off. It won't come off while you're driving or anything. And that actually seems to be a pretty good cover right there. Also, always remember to be safe with solder. You do not want to get this stuff on your hands while it's hot, because it will burn a lot. I can say that from experience. And also, I would recommend even wearing safety goggles while you're using solder, because this stuff flies out into your eyes. That's going to be very bad. Very bad. As you can see, it's still not quite biting yet. So I think... just get a little bit more on there. Not quite. Alright, so I think what we're doing here is I've got a little bit too much solder on the terminal itself. So I'm going to take a little bit of the solder off. Just like that. Alright, and then let's just put it right back on. I think that the first time, I think I overdid it just a little bit. Pretty cool. Alright, and that should be really it. You can always touch it up just a little bit. And also, there are certain tools that are made that you can, you know, have a cleaner connection there. But that's about as good as I'm going to get it. And it seems that it's pretty strong. It is very hot still, so once, as it cools down more, it will obviously get harder. But then all you have to do is just connect the motor wires back up to the ESC wires, and you should be all set. So... still a little bit warm, but really, that's it. So, yep, that is how you solder a motor wire. I'm sure people could do a little bit better than I did. I'm not very good at soldering, but when it comes to the point that I have to do it, I do pull out my soldering iron and use it on the motor, because I would rather try to solder back the motor wire first than have to replace the whole motor. So, thank you everyone for watching. Please like and subscribe. Always be safe when using a soldering iron, and I'll see you all next time on the RC Genius.